going, guys? Me, David Dirk, Kirk, Facilier. Welcome back to another episode of Madden 17, New York Giants Online Franchise with Matt. Today, it is going to be another edition of Sunday Night Football, as will be the Indianapolis Colts taking on the New York Giants. Let's get right into it. The Indianapolis Colts are fifth in rushing yards total, and they are sixth in rushing yards allowed, which means they run the ball well, they stop the run well, so pretty much the run game just sucks against the Indianapolis Colts, because they'll run it down your throat, and they will beat you by stopping you with the run. And a little bit of a rivalry here, the Giants actually picked Deshaun Benford, who has superstar development and was the Heisman winner in the draft, over David Woodbury, who has superstar development, and Woodbury trying to get a little bit of revenge here against the team that did not pick him. He's a great linebacker for the Colts. And great stats. Like I just said, he has superstar development, so he obviously is good. But so does Benford. We are stacked on defense. We've got to be able to stop their run game. I'm thinking we're able to do it. We have one of the best front sevens in the league. And this game is underway as Matt Prater boots this one deep out the back of the end zone. That's going to set up Andrew Luck at the 25-yard line. He has one touchdown, zero picks, 236 yards, and a 72 completion percentage. Great game last week. First and 10 right now. Andrew Luck is going to fire it out to Philip Dorsett. Dorsett with speed all the way up to the 50-yard line. First and 10. Handoff to Duke Johnson Jr. He's going to take that one for a couple. And now let's take a look at the offensive line. Ryan Kelly, the man out of Alabama. They added a lot of talent to that offensive line. And it does actually look sort of solid. T.Y. Hilton is going to be the threat. We've got to find a way to shut him down. He is a big-time player anyway right here. Second and 7. That is caught by Dwayne Allen for the first down. First and 10. Luck feeling the pressure. He's going to fire it underneath the T.Y. Hilton, who's going to muscle his way forward close to a first down. Second and inches right here. Hand off to Duke Johnson, and he is for sure going to pick it up as he's brought down by Quan Alexander. First and 10. Hand off to Duke Johnson right up the middle of the entire defense, and Duke Johnson Jr., the former Miami Hurricane, takes that one all the way into the end zone for a touchdown, and the extra point is going to be good. So it is 7-0 Indianapolis Colts as they used up about 3 minutes on that drive. Adam Humphreys back to return now inside his own 10-yard line, and he's going to bring this one out shy of the 25-yard line. And out comes Eli Manning. He struggled a bit last week, a few errors, but hopefully he can be good this week. Overall, I think he did pretty good. He did lead our offense, as we could not establish the run game at all. First and 10 underneath Sterling Shepard on the drag. He'll take that for a first down. First and 10, another drag route, this time by Nolan Meyer. He'll get to the edge and get the first. This is going to be first and 10 now from the 48-yard line. Brashad Perryman on the drag route to the other side, and he makes a move and gets down to the 33. The Giants are driving, and they're driving fast. First and 10, deep pass to Nolan Meyer. He makes the catch in the end zone for the touchdown. And did you see who he caught it over? He caught it over David Woodbury. Oh, my gosh. The rivalry continues as Meyer gets the nice touchdown grab. Manning recognized he was matched up against a linebacker, and Nolan Meyer's way too talented and just too big of a mismatch to cover. First and 10, Luck under pressure just floats that one away. And now let's take a look at the New York Giants defense. Again, our front seven has got to step up to stop Duke Johnson Jr. We let up a rushing touchdown on the last drive. Hopefully they can get it done. Right there you can see is Deshaun Benford. He is going to be our starting left outside linebacker, of course, for this year and many more years to come. He's young, superstar development, and the replacement for Devin Kennard from last year as he hit free agency. Second and 10, handoff to Johnson. He's going to take that one for 8. And then on 3rd and 2, he's going to pick up the first down. He's starting off very, very fast on the ground. First and 10, that one's going to be batted down at the line of scrimmage. Second and 10, another handoff to Duke Johnson. This time he's going to be stonewalled by Olivier Vernon. 3rd and 6 from the 40-yard line. This is Andrew Luck, a lot of time in the pocket, but it eventually runs out, and he floats it down to T.Y. Hilton, who is way out of bounds. Pat McAfee back to return, one of my favorite players in the entire NFL, and he's going to get this one to Adam Humphreys, who's going to take this one past the 20 and is brought down immediately. First and 10 now from the 22. Manning moving around to the pocket. He's going to get sacked by Lamar Houston. Second and 16 right here. Manning moving around again, tries to force one to Nolan Meyer, and that one's going to be batted down. And now let's take a look at the offensive line. Eric Flowers and Brandon Cota struggled a lot last week. Hopefully they can rebound. And Paul Perkins needs to improve on the ground, and that is about it. Odell Beckham Jr., obviously our best player on our entire team. 3rd and 16, Kota is unable to block Anderson, and Anderson makes the pass fall incomplete because he hit Manning as he threw. Fourth and 16 right here. T.Y. Hilton back to return. He'll take this one out to the 34-yard line. That sets up Andrew Luck on first and 10. He's going to hand it off to Duke Johnson Jr. for a gain of one. Second and 9. That's going to be a sack. Quan Alexander in the backfield. He had 2 sacks last week. Gets one on Luck this week. Third and 15. Jason Pierre-Paul causing pressure. And Andrew Luck has to float that one away. Matt McAfee. That's what I was about to say. Pat McAfee, holy crap, is back to punt, and he's going to get this one to Adam Humphries, who's going to run out of bounds at the 30-yard line. First and 10. This is Manning back in the pocket. He's going to fire one, and it's intercepted by David Woodbury, trying to force it again to Nolan Meyer, I believe that was. And that time, David Woodbury makes him pay for it as he sets up Andrew Luck with great field position. First and 10. Luck flushed out, breaks away, but he's brought down by none other than, guess who? Deshaun Benford. That's a loss of 4 on the play as Benford answers right back. And then on the very next play, that's Darquez Dennard in the backfield hitting Andrew Luck. But unfortunately, that is going to be a face mask, even though it didn't even look like he grabbed the front of his helmet. But it doesn't matter. That sets up a first and 10 for Andrew Luck as he floats that one away. No one was open. Second and 10 right here. Handoff to Duke Johnson. That's Landon Collins stonewalling him in the backfield. Great play right there by Collins. Third and 10 from the 28-yard line. Luck steps up, fires one along the sideline. It is caught by Dante Moncrief, but it appears that he is out of bounds. They actually ruled initially that he was in bounds, but you can clearly see that his right foot was in fact out of bounds. So on fourth and 10 from the 28-yard line, they are going to kick the field goal to put them up 10-7 with 9 minutes left to go in the second quarter. Back to return is Borio, and he is going to let that one sail out the back of the end zone. First and 10, play action fake right here. Manning looking deep, but he's hit as he throws, and the ball falls incomplete. Pressure there again. Second and 10, another blitz, and that's going to be Anderson this time on the sack, beating Brandon Cota. Third and 18, Manning fires one right across the middle of the field, and Beckham beats his man to make the catch and pick up the first down. Big play right there. First and 10, handoff to Paul Perkins. He's going to get about 11 or 12 on that gain. First and 10 again. Paul Perkins with speed accelerates right through the hole, now down to the 28-yard line. First and 10 again, another handoff to Perkins. This time he's going to be stopped in the backfield for a loss of 2. Second and 12 underneath the Beckham on the drag. He's going to get the first down, it appears. And that's going to set up a first and 10 from inside the red zone. Right across the middle of the field to Adam Humphries. He's now down at the 11. Second and 3. Manning quick dropback's going to find Nolan Meyer trying to get the edge, but he's brought down shy of the goal line. First and goal from the 3. Quick pass over the middle. It is caught by Breshad Perryman, who gets the touchdown. And that's going to put the Giants up 14-10 here after the extra point by Matt Prater. And speaking of Matt Prater, he's going to boot this one deep with 5 minutes left to go in the second quarter. Back to T.Y. Hilton, who's going to return from inside his own 2-yard line. He's going to bring this one out shy of the 25 to the 24. First and 10, play action fake. Luck under pressure. He's hit as he throws by Darquez Dennard. Great play right there. Luck is 3 for 10. Terrible start for him, actually. Make that 3 for 11 as he just throws that one away. Third and 10. That's wide open Dante Moncrief along the sideline, as he has a 4-12 completion. That's just terrible. What is going on with Andrew Luck? And the only thing they're able to do is run the ball, and they can't even do it right there as Duke Johnson Jr. loses a yard. Third and 12, he floats that one away. Make it 4 for 13 for 66 yards. Luck is struggling greatly as Pat McAfee will punt that one out the back of the end zone, which sets Manning up on the 20-yard line. This is going to be a pass out to Paul Perkins. He's going to pick up 3 on the play. Second and 7. Manning looking deep for Beckham. He has the man. Beckham beat his man again. Beckham 5. Touchdown, Giants. And that is going to be another touchdown for OBJ. 77 yards. And a great play right there to put the Giants up 21-10 with 3 minutes left to go in the quarter. And I'm forgetting our coach's name. Why can't I? Ben McAdoo. Ben McAdoo wants to score another touchdown. We have 3 timeouts and the 2-minute warning, so we need to get a stop here and get Andrew Luck off the field to pretty much ice this game and hopefully score a touchdown right here. Second and 10 underneath. That one is going to be caught. No, it is going to be out of bounds. Third and 10. Luck struggling greatly under pressure. Fires this one to the sideline to Philip Dorsett, who is stopped by Janoris Jenkins right before he crosses the first down marker to make it 4th and inches from the 38-yard line. They're going to punt this one away back to Humphries, who's going to fair catch it in the end zone. Underneath right there, that is not going to be caught by Lance Dunbar. second and 10. Manning, as he throws, Eric Flowers lost his battle against his man, and now on third and 10 from the 20, right across the middle of the field. That's the same play that got picked off by Woodbury that time, but once again, Nolan Meyer beats him. Again, right over the middle of the field to Nolan Meyer. He gets it now to the 49-yard line. First and 10 with a minute 15 left. The Giants have two timeouts underneath the Nolan Meyer. He makes another catch brought down by Woodbury. Second and 5 underneath again to Nolan Meyer as he's once more brought down by David Woodbury. Third and 4 quick across the middle of the field, and Will Ty is going to be stopped shy of the first down marker. Fourth and 2, Giants going for it here. Very aggressive play call underneath to Adam Humphreys, who's going to get the catch and run out of bounds at the 29-yard line. 18 seconds left. Manning, as he throws, they have two timeouts. Second and 10 from the 29. This is going to be Paul Perkins getting away from his guy, getting out of bounds after picking up the first down, and add on 15 to that as it was a late hit out of bounds. That sets up the Giants with great striking distance with 11 seconds left and two timeouts. Manning looking for the end zone right here, but he's going to fumble the football, and it's recovered by the Indianapolis Colts. And that pretty much just ends the whole New York Giants drive there at the end of the half. And going into the half, it is going to be 21-10, New York Giants. We are just outplaying them in every single aspect right now. Andrew Luck is struggling greatly. No one is open, and a lot of pressure is getting to Andrew Luck. And let's see what happens here in the second half as we are back to return. This is Adam Humphreys returning from inside his own 10-yard line. He's going to bring this one out to the 25 exactly. First and 10 right here. Manning in the shotgun formation. He's going to fire it to Beckham, who's just standing there right between the zones. He's going to get 9, second and 1. Manning's going to fumble the ball again. Anderson gets the strip. Anderson picks it up. No, rather Ray. Whoops, that's my mistake. Ray. Is Sean Ray? I don't even know who that is, but he gets the sack, the strip sack, and he picks it up and goes all the way. Now Andrew Luck here going for 2, trying to deny him, and that is going to be Deshaun Benford sacking Andrew Luck on the 2-point conversion to keep this a 5-point game. This is Adam Humphreys once again back to return. Manning has got to be able to hold on to the football better. Great play by Ray, though. First and 10. Manning play action fake. Manning looking deep. It's tipped up in the air and intercepted by E.J. Gaines. And Beckham is going to tackle him at the 9-yard line. First and 10. Handoff to Duke Johnson Jr. He's going to be brought down from behind by Quan Alexander. Second and 9. Luck, dangerous play as he backed up into his end zone. That was almost a throwaway, which would have resulted in a safety. Right here on 3rd and 9, though, that's going to be Jason Pierre-Paul off the edge and sacking him on the 1. Pat McAfee back to kick. A great punt right there by McAfee to get it out of their zone. And this is going to be Adam Humphreys returning this one across the 50-yard line to the 49. 1st and 10 right here. Underneath a wild pass by Eli Manning. That was almost going the other way. I don't know what he saw right there, but it was not good. Will Tyon now on the out pass, and he's going to take that one for a first down. 1st and 10 play action fake from the 37 right across the middle. Almost intercepted again. Manning is really forcing them here in this game. I don't know why. Rashad Perryman on the out pass. He gets 5. 3rd and 5 right here. Feeling the pressure. Manning's going to get it off to Rashad Perryman again, and he's going to take it inside the 22, the 19. 1st and 10. Manning's going to fire it to Will Ty across the middle of the field, and he's going to be down now at the 14. 2nd and 5, man in motion. Manning underneath the Sterling Shepard, who was the man in motion, and he's going to take this one down to the 5-yard line. 5 minutes left to go in the third quarter. Out past the Will Ty, and he powers forward right through David Woodbury and gets the touchdown. The rivalry continues. Woodbury led up 2 touchdowns, but he also got an interception that led to Indianapolis Colts points. So you can think of it whatever you want to think, but I think we're up on this guy. I just stuttered so badly right there. 1st and 10, handoff to Duke Johnson Jr. He's stopped by Deshaun Benford. 2nd and 8, that's gonna be Quan Alexander and Jason Pierre-Paul stopping Duke Johnson. 3rd and 10, Luck has to float that one away as he is 5 for 17 for 75 yards. What is going on with Andrew Luck today? He is throwing everything away as this is going to be Adam Humphreys back to return, and he's going to take this one out to the 39-yard line. 1st and 10, handoff to Paul Perkins. The Giants trying to kill a lot of clock right here. 2nd and 5, it's going to be a fake, and Manning under pressure just has to float that one away. They were trying a little trickery, and it did not work. 3rd and 5 from the 44. Deep pass to Beckham, and he has him again! Beckham 10-5! Touchdown, Giants! As Beckham gets his second touchdown of the day, 56 yards to put the Giants up 35-16 after this extra point. And this game is pretty much over as the Giants have double plus three of what the Indianapolis Colts have. That punt, or kick rather, is going to go out the back of the end zone. Here's Quan Alexander stopping Duke Johnson for a loss of one. Second 11, play action fake. Luck all day long this time. He's heaving it deep, landing Collins back there, and he's going to bat it down away from the receiver. I'm not sure who that was, but great play right there by Landon Collins. Third and 11 underneath the Duke Johnson Jr., as that is going to be yet another three and out for the Indianapolis Colts. So back to return once more is Adam Humphries from inside his own 20-yard line. He's going to weave through the defense and take this one out to the 29. First and 10. Now 2 minutes left to go in the third quarter. Underneath pass to Paul Perkins. Perkins accelerates, and he's going to pick up about 20 on that play. First and 10, handoff to Perkins, and he's going to be stopped by a sea of Colts for a gain of one. Second and 9. Manning today, what am I saying? Manning has all pressure. Manning has all day to throw the ball. And once again, he does as he finds Sterling Shepard for the first down on third and one. Now from the 39-yard line, this is going to be underneath the Adam Humphries. He's going to take this one for the first down and a little bit more. First and 10, another handoff to Perkins. He's going to take this one for about one. Second and 9, another handoff to Paul Perkins. And the Giants right here, you can see how the play clock is just winding down. They're trying to milk them for all that the clock is worth. And on third and 7, that's going to be Sterling Shepard picking up the first down. So it extends this drive. And look at all the time going off the clock. It's a beautiful thing to watch. Second and 2 right here, underneath pass to Nolan Meyer, who's going to get dropped at the 2-yard line. First and goal. Quick pass out to Will Tye, and Will Tye is in for his second touchdown of the day. Will Tye having a big day, and the Giants are going to capitalize, and there's only 6 minutes left to go. So the Giants, they killed off the third quarter, and they killed off 4 minutes, which is about almost half of the 10-minute quarters that I play. So the Giants are just milking everything, and it is fantastic as the score is 42-16. There's literally no hope for Andrew Luck, who has only completed 6 of 19. First and 10. Big pass, though, to Dwayne Allen. Now to the 50. And Landon Collins is injured. You cannot hit that big of a man that freaking hard. Hopefully Collins will be okay. And I'll just give you a spoiler alert. He is okay. He just won't return for this game, as Corey Cleveland is going to be back there to replace him like he did earlier this season. First and 10 from the 50. Now this is Luck. Quick pass underneath to Dwayne Allen. And he's going to be brought down for only a gain of 3. Second and 7. Out pass right there. Great catch by the receiver, who gets the first down. Now across midfield from the 40. Luck rolls out to his right. Throws to his left. Great play right there, as he's going to find his man all the way down to the 4-yard line. First and goal. Tipped up in the air. And it's intercepted by Darian Thompson. And this game is all but over. Just to add insult to injury. Wow, what a great play right there by Darian Thompson, as it was tipped up in the air, and he made that catch around 300-pound Goliaths, and just a great catch. Like, I would not run into the middle of the trenches to go up and catch that interception. That would just hurt. John Bostic is going to get a face mask penalty, and yeah, this game is just pretty much over. The Giants trying to milk the clock right here. 10 rushes for 51 yards for Paul Perkins. He's trying to add to that right here as he fights through two Colts, and he's going to pick up two on the play. Third and 8 right here across the middle of the field. It's Odell Beckham Jr., who they have not been able to cover all day long. And Manning, look at his stats right here. Well, if he throws another pass, just look at the top of the screen. Look at his stats. He has over 400 yards and about 6 touchdowns, I believe. So he's just having a perfect game, as that's Dunbar on the screen on third and 11. That's not going anywhere, but it doesn't really matter, because right here, Brad Wing is going to run out the clock, punt this one away to T.Y. Hilton, and that is going to be the end of the game. So the Giants come out on top here, 42-16 at the Giants Stadium. So a great home stand right here by the Giants. They looked really, really good, especially Eli Manning, Odell Beckham Jr., even Will Tye, Nolan Meyer. I mean, our whole offense was on fire. Sterling Shepard had a nice catch over the middle of the field to extend the drive. And overall, I think we did very, very well. Our running game sort of got started, not to where I would like it, like when we had Rashad Jennings, but still, it was pretty fine. And of course, our defense was phenomenal. Our corners, safeties, our entire secondary was perfect in shutting down Andrew Luck's receivers, T.Y. Hilton, all them, Philip Dorsett, who has a lot of speed. So does T.Y. Hilton. Both guys have a lot of speed, and it takes a lot to shut them down. Great play right there by Nolan Meyer, just to run right past David Woodbury, as that is going to be Deshaun Benford 1, David Woodbury 0, and that is pretty much going to be That's pretty much it. I have literally nothing else to say except for the stats at the end of this video. Odell Beckham Jr. again had 2 touchdowns. Great game by him. And that's going to be Ray. Yeah, the one thing we could maybe critique is our offensive line. We just struggled there a bit. The Colts had 4 takeaways, 2 fumbles, and 2 interceptions, I believe. And we'll take a look at the individual stats. But look at that, 454 passing yards is insane. And look at Eli Manning, 36 for 47, 468 passing yards, 6 touchdowns, 2 picks. Phenomenal. Paul Perkins, 13 carries, 52 yards. And OBJ with 8 receptions, 210 yards, and 2 touchdowns. And I believe that is going to be the end of this episode, guys. Comment, subscribe, and your veggies. Go to school. Dan Carr Films out. Peace!